Hello and welcome. This is Justice with Tablet Pro, and I'm really excited to show you some progress on this since the last video. This is OneNote. Over here on the left, we have the artist pad. So we have keyboard modifiers, win key, undo, redo, we can color pick. That is not new or surprising for those who are familiar with this channel. However, what I've been working on is this. So this is the Apple Pencil 2. I'm using an iPad mini. This is version 6 and it's lovely. I love the size because I can actually just grab it with one hand. You can lock the rotation so it doesn't spin like this also, which is actually really useful in drawing programs because you can turn it in. I'll show you later. All right, so here's what we're doing. I set it up so that I can use tilt on the stylus to open the radial menu. This is really, really cool. We've made a lot of improvements here so that you can work in OneNote on the go. This is the cellular version of the iPad, which means I can connect. I'm using the business something or another from Splashtop. So I can connect and use Apple Pencil pressure. That setting is right here. Enable remote Apple Pencil. All right, so look at this. I'm switching to the blue stylus and yellow. Still getting used to this. Back to blue, green, orange, highlighter, eraser. Lasso, which we don't have anything to lasso. Oh, we do. And this radio menu, I have two different radio menus here. So you can have, I think it's 12 per radio menu. So 24 different things here. If you want to do this and have the full screen, you can hide the touch part of it and just use the radio menu to do and undo whatever it is that you're wanting to do. Now I have this working in Blender and Rebel in the video I shared yesterday. What we're planning on doing is adding a little touch button. I can show you an actual preview of that. And what you do is you'd press on the button and it would open up the radial menu here. Woo! And this makes using Windows apps on your iPad a whole lot easier. And part of what I've wanted for a long time is I really wanted to have a setup where I was able to use my full Windows computer comfortably in all sorts of different locations. So switch here to full screen mode. One thing that I want to do is I want to have this full screen trackpad mode so you can use these menus easily and just very quickly switch between using a trackpad. All right, so let me give you the quick demonstration here of this. Let's open this up. We're going to go into settings. Settings actually for the radial menu right here. Open radial menu A when the pen tilts. We have that. Always display a radial menu toggle button. This menu still needs some work, so we're going to be working on this and adding a few additional options. So let's look at how this looks at the moment. So right now, I'll open this up, and then I have a button. The button is actually up here. When you click on it, it reopens the radial menu. This button will be draggable and will look a bit different. So you should be able to bring this down. I may make it a little larger. I'm not sure yet, but basically I'm wanting it so that it's easily accessible from your left hand. So you can trigger there and you're not having to do anything with your right hand besides using the stylus or the radial menu or whatever. All right, that is the update. I'm going to share a full walkthrough as I get a little further along. So we'll be looking at things like latency, how to improve the latency so that it's really nice and easy to use. Right now, let's do this way. Right now, using it is actually quite quick. This is running, the screen is shows 22 frames a second, which can be 40, 50. The business version of this software, it says it goes up to 240 frames per second. I have no idea how they can do that, but that's what it says. All right, I will have more on this channel about this. If you are interested in running full Windows apps on an iPad remotely with wonderful, easy to use controls, then subscribe to this channel. I'll have more on this if you want to see how certain programs work. Part of the reason I'm doing this, I spent a long time learning how to use the apps that I use. I love Rebel 7 Pro. I don't want to learn Procreate. I have Procreate. I have a whole bunch of different apps on my device. I have Clip Studio, PaintStorm, Designer 2, Ibis Paint, Concepts, ArtRage, Medibang Paint, Sketchbook, Art Studio Pro, Procreate, all sorts of different ones on my device. And Art Studio Pro is decent. I like it. I like it better at the moment than Procreate for a couple different reasons. However, I don't want to learn a bunch of new apps. It slows down my muscle memory. I work much slower, and I have to think a lot about what I'm doing instead of what I'm trying to accomplish in the software. So if you like that idea, put a little note in the comment section that said, I would like to know more. I have a Discord channel where you can join and learn about what we're doing and be notified when more solutions come available. If there's an application you want to see, there's something that you're wondering how does it work or how can it work on a small Windows device, whether that's an iPad or a tablet, put that program name in the comment section also. All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. I'll have a few more coming shortly on the iPad mini setup. Again, this works with any size iPad. All right, until next time, stay creative and have a wonderful day.